All the rabbits were busy. Oh, hello, hands. You're going to do a magic trick for me? Okay, you got three cards. The center card is the black card. I'll keep my eye on the black card. Those two are the red card. Turn it around. No, see, I told you. That's the black card. Oh, that's the most amazing thing I ever didn't see. Heavy.
Gentlemen, from the stage of the National Arts Center of Canada, an evening of magic and illusion starring Sherry Lewis.
Some folks say that magic is where the hand is quicker than the eye. They go on to say that's all you have to do in order to qualify.
Right-hand lamb.
Shari's guests this evening will be an international cast of the world's greatest magicians, starring the master of grand illusion, Mark Wilson, assisted by Nani Darnell in the beautiful and amazing Azra Levitation. The world's foremost escape artist, the amazing Randy, who will attempt the Great Houdini's dangerous milk pan escape.
I'll explain how that trick works to you later. And then again, maybe I won't.
The magical comedy of the great Tom Company. And from Holland, the celebrated magical mime artistry of Flip. Assisting Shari, the amazing Lamb Chop.
second hands.
And Sherry's special guests, the stars of the National Ballet of Canada, Karen Kane and Frank Augustine. In the premiere performance of a magical ballet, Beauty and the Beast.
I tell you, I really fall for magic. Thank you very much. Go ahead, do it.
Do what?
Introduce me.
Oh, come on, honey, you've already been introduced.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Jeez, I missed it. It's my favorite part. Do it again.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting my favorite supporting act, Miss Lam...
Oh, no.
What do you mean, oh, no?
I'm not your supporting act. Oh, she kills me.
What is so funny?
What is so funny is that I don't support you. You support me. These people don't want to see you. They want to see me. I am the star. Thank you very much. Now for my first mental trick. Ladies and gentlemen, if you can guess how many pennies I have in my purse, I'll give you all seven.
Lamchop, I don't think you got it.
No?
No, no. As a matter of fact, I think you could learn a lot from our first guest.
Who is he?
He is that master of grand illusion, Mark Wilson.
Now we're going to present a classic of magic, an illusion that many people have heard of, but few have actually seen. Now remember as you watch that we use no camera trickery. There is no trick photography of any kind. Watch.
never been a hostess at a magic party before, and I just forgot my manners. Please, excuse me. At my party, your every wish is my command. Think of a drink, and the drink you think is right at hand. If you'd like some punch, sir, have some punch, sir. Punch with lunch, sir, is grand. But if you have a thirst, sir, dry water first, sir. Water for your thirst, sir, is much in demand. Drink all the water that you will, and then your cup with punch I'll fill. Now you may ask, how will I be able to fill all the glasses with punch at the table? That's very obvious. I'll have to arrange for the water in the pitcher to make a little change, a very, very strange and very simple change. But if you have a thirst, sir, don't hesitate, sir. Raise your voice loud and clear. Just because it's lunch, sir, you needn't have punch, sir. I still can give you water right here. Yes, if it's water you want with your lunch, sir, I can fill you up. But if it's punch you want with your lunch, then raise your cup.
Thank you. You know, all the magicians who are here with us tonight have international reputations. Good international reputations. But this next magician has a reputation that reached us all the way from Holland. And so we flew him in at enormous expense for your pleasure and for mine. Well, it really wasn't such enormous expense. We didn't have to fly in his son or his wife or his assistant or his props or his equipment or his anything, because he works alone, all alone. And I know that you'll agree that that's quite enough when you meet Flip.
Thank you.
It's in the presentation of magic rather than in the tricks that one magician is different from another. And all I want to tell you about the great Tomsoni is he is different. The great Tomsoni and Company!
Thank you. wonder why I'm sitting on the newspaper. You may be one of those people who think the only purpose for a newspaper is to train the dog. That's a little joke. Well, these are not just the papers. These are the funny papers. And one of the most famous magicians of all comes from the funnies. And so tonight, you lucky people, here on Magic, we're going to breathe life, you know, like that, into Mandrake the Magician. Where's that picture? Oh, there it is.
Nothing's very funny in the funnies. If you ignore the ducks and mice and bunnies, they're basically all tragedy. Oh, nothing's very funny in the funnies. What a lousy life for little orphan Annie. Where's her daddy? Where's her mammy? Always in a jam, no matter how hard she tries. No home, no hope, no eyes. Nothing's very funny in the funnies. In the 40s, they were comics, they were crummies. They're basically all tragedy. Oh, nothing's very funny in the funnies. World War II's invaded. The Sunday funny papers. Blondie's selling victory bonds instead of cutting capers.
Evil Nazi scientists are out to rule the earth.
A joke, Lucas, Superman, and even Mary Worth. From darkness to metropolis, you rarely hear a laugh. Since the Sunday papers got called out by the trap. Nothing's very funny in the funnies. If you ignore the ducks and mice and bunnies, they're basically all tragedy. Oh, nothing's very funny in the funnies.
Mandrake, want to dance?
Where you going, Buster? I am a princess, you know.
Nigel!
Oh, hello, Manny.
It's 8:45.
So?
Don't you realize it's time for us to save humanity? Look at the time. Where have you been?
Again? Oh, Manny! You mean you drug me all the way downtown just to save humanity again?
That's what I said, Nar.
Manny, I keep telling you, I don't have the time to keep running around every time humanity needs a saving. You know, I got princess things to do.
Narda? What about the preservation of freedom and human dignity?
I tell you the truth, Manny. I don't think you got it in you. I mean, look at Batman. Or Superman, or Captain Marvel. Oh, Manny, Manny, they look modern. You look like a doorman. Manny, you know, nowadays, you gotta be a superhero. What is there that is so special about you?
I can move mountains. I can part the sea just by gesturing. Hypnotically, I can tell futures. I can read minds.
He can guess your weight. He can tell you the time.
I can stop the sun.
He can stop the daughter.
I can vanish to Mexico.
But he can't drink the water.
I stop women and children from being molested. Just one simple gesture. Once got boss arrested. Blind with wonders.
Thanks, I'd rather see.
I can give you the world.
Thanks, I'll take three.
I hypnotically gesture, the world is my stage.
Get out the hook, put him back in his cage.
Him a god.
Him a fraud.
No, I'm not, you.
Thank you.
community saving stuff because, you know, I have a turban fitting at 5:30, and it... Oh, I gotta go. I'm
going. Wait. You seem to have forgotten. You see, I can gesture us there hypnotically.
Oh, Manny. Really?
Sure.
All right, go ahead. Wait a second. Oh, no, Manny, you didn't do it. No, we didn't get transported anyplace.
Narda, you don't understand. That part doesn't work. What I really do is I gesture hypnotically. Now they think that we're gone, but in reality, we're still here.
What do we do if we really want to be there in real life?
Catch a cab?
Taxi!
Taxi!
How about the subway?
So still on your side.
Riding on a subway with a paper this size presents certain problems I have found. The turning of a page is sure to disturb people who are standing all around. So I've worked out an answer I think is sound. Now you mustn't laugh if I tear this paper in half, then in half again, 'cause it's still too big to read. And though it may seem strange to you to see me tear this paper in two, I'm afraid half as much is all I need. But with a magic word or two, I'll spread my paper out on the floor. And 1, 2, 3, hey, you can say my paper's as it was
bad trip, but can she gesture hypnotically? You see, I can Hey, boss! You see this?
Ah, big deal.
Now, if I gesture hypnotically, I can make people think that
no,
we're good.
I mean this news story.
Humanity saved Kermit. Wait a minute. If humanity's saved, who am I going to gesture to?
Oh, you and your gestures. You know, I should have listened to my mother. My mother said, get yourself a nice boy who wears tights and is faster than a speeding bullet. My mother, did I listen? No. Now, what are we going to do?
What does a hypnotic gesture do when humanity has given the gesture to you?
Who needs a girl whose job application says experience, princess, and some levitation?
Or unemployed African king seeking work comes complete with fez and leopard skin shirt?
Oh, where does an out-of-date comic strip go? We just wait until the 70s and become a Broadway show. Go, go, away. We'll be back, Echelon, we'll be back, gesturing hypnotically, so don't be sad, just pretend.
that when the 40s will be popular on old Broadway. You'll see. We'll be back, we'll be back. Gesturing hypnotically.
To tell me about this next entertainer, everybody used the same phrase. They said, this guy's outstanding in his field. I hate that phrase. It's outstanding in his field, you know? You can't tell if the guy's a celebrity or a farmer. And this man is no farmer. What he does is probably the most dangerous thing in all of magic. He is the world's leading escape artist. And tonight, for us, he's going to do the milk can escape. Would you please help me to welcome the amazing Randy!
Thank you. Thank you and good evening. You see before you a steel can. This can is securely welded and riveted together in such a way that it is absolutely airtight and watertight. There's a steel lid that goes along with it and six steel hasps. At the same moment that my head goes beneath the water, I invite you all here in the theater and at home as well to take a deep breath as I have done. Then estimate for yourself at the time that you have to exhale whether or not you could survive this watery tomb. Now, in doing this performance, ladies and gentlemen, I take full credit for the performance only, because the invention that you are about to witness, this particular illusion, was invented, designed, conceived in all ways by the greatest escape artist who ever lived, the great, late Harry Houdini.
Dangerous as it looks. There is no question that, in performing it, there is a very real possibility of drowning. Before the steel can was filled with water backstage, the amazing Randy allowed us to examine it thoroughly. We could find no false bottom, nor any other opening except through the top, which is now sealed with padlocks, which were purchased by our staff at a hardware store just before the show. There is no trapdoor in the stage. In fact, the can is sitting on a solid, waterproof floor cover that we had made specially so that you could see just how much water was displaced when he was sealed inside. As you can see, we have cameras at the front and the back to make sure no one could possibly enter to assist him without us seeing. The amazing Randy is alone, locked inside that steel can filled with water. If he does not emerge by the time the music ends, his assistants will break open the locks and release him before he drowns. If he does escape, it will mean that the amazing Randy has accomplished the impossible. Kane and Frank Augustine.
Karen Kane and Frank
Augustine.
The magicians?
Dancers.
What are they going to do?
They're going to do a magical ballet.
What are we waiting for?
Karen Kane and Frank Augustine. They're warming up.
They're warming up together?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, it's going to be hot around here.
It's
Listen, while we're waiting, I got an idea.
What?
Why don't I tell you a story?
Go ahead. Pick a story from 1 to 10.
Lamb chop.
No. Don't show it to me.
Sweetheart.
I bet you picked the story of the Beauty and the Beast.
You're absolutely right. Only I'm not going to tell the story of the Beauty and the Beast because Karen Kane and Frank Augustine are warmed up.
Oh!
And so we're going to have the magical ballet of the Beauty and the Beast.
Oh, and wait a second. I have to say the magical words.
What magical words?
Once upon a time, in an enchanted forest.
Thank you.
also appearing on tonight's show were Billy Van as Mandrake the Magician, Joel, the Man of Mystery, as Hans, and the dancers of Les Ballet Jazz.